Hello, everyone. Welcome to the Daily Message. This is your daily reading for tomorrow, Monday, March 21st, 2022. For all signs that may be watching, and this is a general reading for the collective, so it may not resonate with you specifically. As I always say, for the most accurate reading with the most accurate outcome, please do come get a personal private tarot reading with either me or your favorite tarot reader out there. If you'd like to book a reading with me, my information is below in the description, also up in the right-hand corner. Click the eye in the sky. That will take you to my scheduling page where you can book a reading at your convenience. And for your reading today, guys, if I can open it. We're using this little deck here, Tarot the Complete Kit by Running Press. You can visit them on the web at www.runningpress.com for more information. All right, I'm also going to pull one of these messages from the Butterfly Oracle Cards for Life Changes. Tomorrow the sun does move into Aries and we have the moon in Scorpio. Some important information there astrologically. So there's definitely a transition going on, which is why I'm using those butterfly cards for tomorrow. So let's see. What is going on for the collective tomorrow? Keep in mind, these are general readings, so they may not resonate with you specifically. And take my readings with a grain of salt, of course. Take what resonates, leave what doesn't. I'll call out the zodiac signs as I see them. So let's go ahead and jump into it, Spirit. What messages do you want to give to the collective for tomorrow? Monday, March 21st. 2022 for all signs that may be watching. We have the High Priestess, the Ace of Swords, and the Nine of Cups. Those came out really fast. Sometimes Spirit is on point like that. At the bottom of the deck, we do have Justice, Libra, we have Pisces, Virgo energy. We have this air sign energy. I really pick up Libra here. You know, the moon is moving out of Libra into Scorpio. We have Scorpio and Pisces energy here. I would interpret this as Piscean energy. I really get this message that someone knows that something is going to make them very happy. And this could be an inner knowing. I could be speaking to someone that is a practitioner. Whenever I get the High Priestess card here, that's pretty much, a tarot reader watching, or it could also be someone that's listening to their intuition here. By this point in time, you know what is going to be your wish fulfillment, what's going to make you truly happy. There shouldn't really be any questions at this point in time is what I'm getting as a message here. Because the scales are perfectly balanced. So that tells me that we also have the Ten of Pentacles underneath there. Now this could be a family situation. This could be a marriage. This could be a relationship. This could be a karmic situation. You know what will make you happy. You know what will satisfy you. You know what ultimately is going to bring you the most pleasure, is going to meet your needs. That's kind of the energy that I'm seeing here. And you can't really go wrong when Justice is here, because it says that this is meant to be, or something is meant to be, or Justice in the upright position is like, it's like, this is right, or this is like the righteous thing to do. So listen to your intuition. You know the truth about your happiness, about your, what satisfies you, what makes you the most happy. And ultimately, that is not selfish. It's human nature to be able to decipher these things in our lifetime. If any of these cards came out reversed, or I also feel like the truth is being spoken tomorrow. Someone could be coming out with the truth. I see something going on with a water fountain. I also see the signs of Pisces and Libra coming out tomorrow. So something could be going on between a Pisces and a Libra. Pomegranates. Pomegranates here. Think of Persephone, who was dragged down to Hades. And the pomegranate seeds represent, I guess it's the feminine energy, it's that feminine essence, but also spring, the end of the winter. I also see pleasure and celebration. You might be getting together with someone outside for drinks or something like that. I see people getting together to do something that brings them happiness, that brings them pleasure. I also see fruit, an apple and an orange, or someone is comparing apples to oranges. If we add everything up here, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, it reduces to a 2, which talks about balance, choice, decision, sometimes indecision, but think of the 2s in the tarot, the 2 of swords, the 2 of cups, the 2 of wands, and the 2 of pentacles. The point is that you already know, your higher self already knows the answer. So why look further? Why question the things that you intuitively know to be true regarding your happiness in this lifetime? It is not wrong. Your intuition is not wrong. All right, let's pull one of these cards here. Like I said, I see Pisces and Libra, Scorpio, Virgo, energies coming out in this reading. We have forgiveness. So this is a theme . It's a pretty butterfly. Just read the card. I'm trying to get it to stand up there. I need to get my, I have a little card stand I could use here. See that? It says, dear one, have you been carrying around anger, guilt, shame, or regrets? This card indicates that it's time to set down these burdens so that you can spread your wings and fly higher. You are guided to release stored emotions and thoughts that may block you. Forgiveness doesn't mean that what others did to you is okay, or that you need to spend time with them. Rather, it means that you are choosing to detox yourself from residual negative thoughts and emotions related to these experiences. Prayer, spending time in nature, cultivating compassion, journaling, support groups, and trauma counseling can help you gain understanding and the motivation to completely forgive. Be sure to forgive yourself for any regrets and release grudges you're holding toward yourself. It's helpful to learn from mistakes made in the past, but not to hang on to them by berating yourself. The point is to increase your confidence and the love in your heart so that you can focus upon your divine purpose. Additional meanings: letting go of the past, adopting a more positive outlook, releasing a toxic relationship with forgiveness, past life healing. So perhaps some of those messages will resonate with you. Thank you so much for tuning in to this daily message. I send you guys off with love and light and healing. And hope you're well. Take care.